Yo, Fresh in the Flesh, back with the statue series. I'm here with the tall, the agile, defensive beast, crazy scorer, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He goes hard in the paint, and he has a quote. He says, you can't win until you learn how to lose. How much does that resonate with you? Because it deeply resonates with me. You see, Kareem must have, he had some losses and he learned from it. And then he had the resilience, the persistence, and he discovered the acceptance and the integrity of losing. Therefore, he became more, which enabled him to win. Okay? So I'm gonna talk about my wrestling career. Okay? My wrestling career was cool because I lost a lot. In fact, I led Pennsylvania in losses. I was 14 and 27. Terrible, right? Well, I own it because of that, I learned so much. Now, I didn't get comfortable with losing. I couldn't stand it. Matter of fact, I was pissed off about it. I didn't want to lose. I couldn't. It was awful. But I learned from every loss. I had great coaches, I had great teammates, and I just kept growing each match. And guess what? That next following year, I went 34 and 16, made it to districts. And it was awesome with a capital A because I learned how to lose. And I got a lot of character virtues out of that, which I talk about often, which led to great success in college and onward. But Kareem here, he learned how to lose. So try and learn how to lose. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to get rejection and learn how to handle it. Because then you become more in the process like Kareem did. You can win championships, have great statistics in life, like my man I'm going to show you in a second. Also, he says, a person could be an integral part in the team, but also they cannot be on the team. One man cannot make a team, he says. You can be an integral ingredient in the team, meaning you can't be the team. There's no I in team, right? So there is an a-hole in team, though. So you gotta have this balance of being a good team player, and because of that will be that key ingredient in the team. So this goes for business, this goes to relationships, sports. How can you fit in with a team and not be the team? This is one thing I learned from Elliot. He says, Dougie, I put brilliant people around me. Business is as simple as that. Get people's strengths and fill them in. That's huge. Last thing about Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, this wise man, he was a yogi. He did yoga very often. So cool, because he was so agile. I mean, he was so lanky, so tall here. What he had to do was yoga. Nobody knows that, but I've heard this recently. He did yoga. So he found out what he was weak in, and he needed to develop strength, flexibility, and balance because of his disadvantages from his advantages. His advantages. So you might be good in one area, but because of that, you might have that. Let's say you're persistent, and that persistence is an overextension. It's a virtue turning into a vice. It can be stubbornness. Well, you can benefit from that by learning how to be more patient and trusting. That's it. Stay fresh. Stay blessed. Stay strong. Peace. Stay bowling.
Mountain of a man. No shadow of a doubt about that.